Welcome to Excel Assembly. Today's video tutorial is for creating a dashboard which transforms this boring task tracker to something like this. You can share the dashboard by publishing the sheet as a web page or download the dashboard as a PDF file. Before we start, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss on the weekly videos we publish. Also, add a comment in the comment section saying I subscribe and I'll make sure to reply to you. So let's get started. First of all, let's look at the task tracker and try to understand it. The first column in my task tracker is the project, and if you can see, I've got 5 projects running right now. Each project has got multiple tasks, and each and every task is assigned to a specific manager over here. There's a start date for every task, and then what we've done is that we have added plausible duration for that particular task. The expected date is a calculation which we got by using the function workday. The workday function assumes that your weekend falls on Saturday and Sunday. If it's some other days, then you can use workday.intl, which is the international workdays, to calculate the expected end date. This is the days completed, which is being filled by the manager, and it showcases how many days out of the total duration have been completed as of now. The progress column is a simple calculation of days completed divided by duration and showcased as a percentage. The budget column showcases the allocated budget for the task and actually something that is being filled by the manager, and it gives details of how much expense has been done till date. So I hope this tracker is something that is easy to understand. You can see that the columns A, B, C, D, E, F are the ones that have been filled at the outset. Days completed is something that's filled by the manager. This is an automatic calculation. Budget is also allocated at the start, and actual expense is the one that is filled by the manager. So there are only 2 columns that are to be filled by the manager, which is days completed and the actual expense. Now let's see how from this particular tracker you can create the beautiful dashboard we just saw. Now let's first of all assign a new tab to this particular dashboard that we're going to create. I'll just press the plus over here, add a sheet, and let me call it dashboard 1. I'll call it my project dashboard and just increase the font size of this particular heading a bit. Now the first thing that I want to showcase in my dashboard is the budgets. How are the actuals looking versus the allocated? In order to do that, let me first of all create a pivot table. And let me open up another tab for creating the pivot table. Add a new sheet from here and let me call it working 1. In order to create a pivot table, I'll go to data, pivot table. First of all, let me select the data range. I'll click on select data range and I'll go back to the task tracker. And from here, I'll select the columns A to J. Press OK and then it'll ask me insert to which sheet, a new sheet or an existing sheet. Now that I already assigned a sheet, I'll go to existing sheet, click over here, select working 1 as the sheet, go back over here and just click the A1 cell and press OK. Check the data range, check the place where the pivot table is to be inserted, and then press create. So now I have the structure for the pivot table ready. I just need to now assign rows and columns. So what do we want for the rows? We want the projects over here. So I'll go over here on the right hand side of the pivot table editor. On rows, I'll click add and then click on project. As soon as I click on the project, you'll see that the projects have been added in the pivot table. Now in the values, I'll add the budget and the actual cost incurred. So go over here, click on values, add. The first thing that I want to add is budget. And after that, I will add actual. You can also see that there's a blank row showing up over here. This is because I selected the entire columns in the task tracker. In order to remove it, what you can do is that you can go to the pivot table editor, select a filter, add the project. And from the project, what you can do is that you can just take out the blank items, uncheck it and press OK. Now here you have the pivot table for the budget versus actual. Now from this project wise budget versus actual pivot table, we'll generate the graphs. But before that, sum optics will just remove the sum of from both budget and actual headings. Alright, now what you can do is just select this entire table, go to insert, chart. By default, a chart will be selected in Google Sheets. You can go to the chart editor on the right hand side and select the chart type. Let's say the first thing that we want is actually a table to be inserted. So I'll click over here, move down, and here you can see a table. Now the significance of this particular table is that it is independent of the cells and it's actually a chart. so you can insert it anywhere you want. Now, I would also want to see a bar chart for budget versus actual. So what I'll do is that I'll just go to the right side of this chart where I can see the three dots, click over here, copy chart, click somewhere here and press Ctrl V or Command V so that a duplicate chart is created. On this particular chart, I'll again press these three dots and press Edit Chart. From the chart type, I'll select this budget versus actual bar chart. Now that I have these two charts, I can just copy them and paste them in the dashboard. Click over here, copy chart, go to dashboard one and press Ctrl V or Command V like this and adjust it here. Then the second one, click over here, copy chart, go to dashboard one, click somewhere and press Ctrl V or Command V and I get the bar chart over here. I can now adjust the height of these two graphs so that they look symmetrical. Let me add a heading over here which says budget check. Let me add some formatting to it as well. Alright, now that I have the budget check with me, I want to go ahead and look for the project progress. So let's get back to the sheet working one. You won't need these charts now, so you can just delete these. Now here what we need is a pivot table that showcases all the projects and then it also shows how many days have been assigned to each project and how many days have been completed. Then we can check for a simple percentage to see the progress of that particular project. So let's insert another pivot table here. You can either go ahead and insert the pivot table the same way that we did earlier or the simpler way would be to just copy this particular table and then paste it over here. Do not use a paste value, otherwise it will be pasted as values. Now what you can do is that you can make changes in the second pivot table. So as far as the rows are concerned, we need all the projects over here, but the values have to change from budget and actual to duration and days completed. So we'll go over here to values, remove budget and remove actual. Now in values, we are going to add duration and then we are going to add days completed. You can just correct the headings over here, remove sum off from here. Now in order to get the progress, you can just add a progress column over here and the function would be simple. It would be equal to days completed divided by the duration. You get an autofill suggestion over here and press yes. Now you need the percentage and in order to do that, you select all of these cells. Go over here in the ribbon and you can see format as percent. Click on it and you get the percentage. You can showcase it as without a decimal. So just click over here twice and here you get the progress. Now we would want the project progress to be shown as gate charts. So what we're going to do is that we're going to select first the project column, the grand total included, press Ctrl or Command and then select the progress one. Once these two columns have been selected, go to Insert, Chart, and then from here in the chart editor, you select Gate Chart. So here you can see that you've got six gate charts, one for each project and then one for the grand total. Now the problem is that the gauges over here need to be worked on. So what we'll do is that we'll again click on these three dots and press Edit Chart. We'll go to Customize and then click on Gauge. Now in the gauge, we need to define what is the minimum and the maximum. So the minimum of course is 0, but the maximum is 100%, which would be 1. If you want, you can also put various range colors so that it becomes easier for someone who is looking at the dashboard to see whether there is a possibility to go over budget. So let's say up to 50% is green, 50 to 75 is yellow and 75 to 100% is red. So for the red color, we'll have a minimum of 75%, which is 0.75 and the maximum would be 1. For yellow, the minimum is going to be 0.5 and the maximum is going to be 0.75. And for green, the minimum is going to be 0 and the maximum is going to be 0.5. Once you're done with it, you can just click anywhere on the spreadsheet and you can see that your gate chart is showing perfectly. Now you can go to your dashboard, dashboard 1, add a new section called Project Progress. You can just go up, copy the format of the budget check header and paste it in the Project Progress header. Now go back to working one, copy the gate chart, go to dashboard one and just paste it over here. You might want to adjust it a bit. And once done, you can see that half of your dashboard is almost ready. Now the next thing to add is the overall task status, as in how many tasks are there, how many have been completed, how many are pending and how many have not yet been started. So let me go back to working one first. We cannot delete this particular gate chart. And here I will add three task statuses. One is not started, other is completed, and the third one would be in progress. Now, the logic to get the number of tasks not started, completed, and in progress is simple. If a task is not started, in the task tracker, the progress percentage will be showing as 0. If it is completed, it will be 100%, and if it is in progress, it will be anywhere between 0% and 100%. So what we're going to do is that we're going to use the COUNTIF and COUNTIFS function. Let's go to not started first, equal to COUNTIF. The range that I'm going to select over here is in the task tracker, the entire column of progress, comma, and it's not started, so it's going to be 0%. For completed, I'll just copy this entire function, paste it over here, and the 0% will be replaced by 100%. And for in progress, I'm going to use COUNTIFS equal to COUNTIFS. Go over here to task tracker. The criteria range one is the progress column. If it is within quotes greater than 0%, comma, again the same column, which is the progress, comma, within quotes less than 100%, quotes close, bracket close, and enter. So now I have this particular data, and I'm going to insert a chart which shows me the task status. Select this entire data, go to insert chart, and what I can do is that instead of a pie chart, I'll use a donut chart like this. You can see that in the pie or the donut chart, I did not need to convert this to percentage. It automatically converts it to a percentage. Click on the three dots over here, copy the chart, go to dashboard one. And first of all, let me just add the heading over here, which says task status. I can just copy the format from the previous heading and paste it over here. And below it, I'm going to paste our chart like this. You might also want to put all the task actual data over here, so you can use a simple equal to and refer it to working one like this, and then copy the cells over here. Add a heading over here, status, number of tasks, and then put it into a table. And then just add borders to this particular table like this. After the task status, you would want to add a manager wise report. So let me just go ahead and add a heading over here. So my first manager is Ben, so let me add the report for Ben first. I'll just mention his name over here. First thing I want is a days report. Here I want to just check total days assigned, days completed, and days pending. In order to get the total days assigned, we are going to use a SUMIF function, which says equal to SUMIF. The range is going to be from the task tracker, the name of the manager, which is column C, comma. The criteria is going to be the name of the manager, which is Ben, this particular cell, comma. And what am I going to add up? I'm going to add up all the days that have been assigned to Ben. So I'll go back to the task tracker and select duration, bracket close, and enter. So a total of 52 days have been assigned to Ben. Now, what I need is days completed. So it's going to be equal to SUMIF. I'll go back to task tracker, select the manager, this entire column, comma, dashboard, select the name of the manager from here, comma, and go back to the task tracker and select days completed column, bracket close and enter. So days completed is 31. Days pending is a simple calculation, which is equal to total days assigned minus the days completed. So this gives me my days report. Let me just format it a bit. Next, for the manager, I'd also want the tasks report. And here I would want completed, not started, and in progress. In the overall task status, I use the COUNTIF function. But here, since I have two criteria, which is the task status as well as the manager name, I'll use COUNTIFS function. So for completed, my function is going to be equal to COUNTIFS. Criteria range one is going to be in the task tracker, the manager column. And the criteria is going to be in the dashboard, the name of the manager, comma. The second criteria range is going to be from the task tracker, the progress column, comma. And the criteria two will be in quotes, 100%. For not started, I'm going to copy this entire function, paste it here, and 100% is going to be replaced with 0%. There are going to be three criteria for in progress, one being the manager name and the other two for the task status, one that it should be greater than 0% and the other it should be less than 100%. So what we can do is that we can do equal to COUNTIFS. Criteria range one will be manager in the task tracker, comma, the actual manager name, comma. We go back to the task tracker to select the range for the progress percentage, comma. In quotes, we'll write greater than 0%, comma, again select the same range for the criteria range 3, comma, and in the actual criteria it is less than 100%, bracket close and enter. Now here what we can do is that we can freeze the reference for the different columns from the task tracker, because we're going to replicate this manager report to other managers as well. So let's go ahead and freeze all the references here. So there's going to be a dollar in front of C and C like this, similarly here as well, and then all the other cells also. Now let's assign a chart to the days report. So I'll only select the days completed and days pending. Go to insert chart. Let me make this chart a bar chart like this and try to squeeze it over here under the days report. Now for the tasks report, I'll insert a donut chart, select all these different statuses, insert chart. From here, I'll select a donut like this and again try to squeeze it below this report. Okay, we know that there are 5 managers in my task tracker. What I need to do is that I need to just replicate this report here and change the name of the manager. Let's say it's Ben over here. If I need the report for Lucy, you can see that it changes to Lucy. But before replicating the manager-wise report, let's try and beautify the graphs a bit one by one. So let's go at the top of a dashboard. First of all, go to View and just remove the grid lines. Once you remove the grid lines, go to this particular graph, edit it, and now let's make some changes to it. Let's say you go to Customize and go to Series and Add Data Labels over here. We don't need the chart title, so you can just delete it from here. And then if you want, you can also remove these particular major and minor lines. You might want a 3D graph. So what you can do is that go to Customize, Chart Style, and then click on 3D. You now get a 3D graph. If you don't want this border for the graph, you can go to Edit, and in Customize Chart Style, you can just remove the border color. You can do similar things to the other charts as well. Alright, so now that you're done with the formatting, let's just replicate the manager-wise report. Let's say I copy these tables from here and paste them over here. I'll use a slightly different color for the header. And here, instead of Ben, I'll use the name Lucy. So you can see that the reports also change accordingly. In order to get the graphs, you can just copy these particular graphs one by one. Copy the chart. Let's say I paste it over here. Press the 3 dots over here and now edit the chart. Now here you can see that it's showing a data range A62, B63, which is this one. Instead of that, I need G62 and H63. This modifies my days report. And similarly, I'll take the tasks report, copy the chart, paste it here, and then modify the data range. So this way I got the report for 2 managers, and I think it should be easier for you to make the reports for the other 3 managers as well. Once you're done with this and you're done with the formatting, your final dashboard will look something like this. If you want to share this dashboard as a web page, you go to File, Publish to Web, a new window pops up. Instead of the entire document, you just select the particular tab that you want to share as a web page and then press Publish. You'll get a URL. You just copy this URL and share it. Alternately, if you want to save this dashboard as a PDF, you can go to File, Download as a PDF. And then you can see this particular dashboard coming as a PDF. Now here you can do some page setup to make sure that the pagination is correct and then share your PDF document with your team. So friends, you saw how easy it is to make those particular dashboards in Google Sheets. A very good thing about Google Sheets is that the dashboards that you make, the graphs are actually live, as in when you make changes in your task tracker, your dashboard also gets updated. And friends, that was the video. A link to this sheet is available in the description. You can just make a copy of this particular sheet that's available as a read-only copy and make whatever changes you want and try it out. So until next time, bye-bye.